See the modulation section of the Odyssey, sat in the middle there. Now we've already played with the LFO, the low frequency oscillator, affecting the pitch of the VCOs and also affecting the pulse width of the VCOs. The Odyssey just has a single dedicated LFO. As we've already seen, it can produce sine wave output, supposedly. I think it might actually be triangle wave or filtered triangle wave, but it's called sine wave, and the little symbol on the front panel shows a sine wave. It can also produce square wave output, but so far the only thing that we've seen that it can send the square wave output to is the pitch of oscillator 1. Now the LFO just has a single control for its frequency, and that is marked as going from between 0.2 Hz up to 20 Hz. So it doesn't get up into the audio range, so you can't do audio rate frequency modulation with it. Now in some ways the setup of the Odyssey could be seen as a bit of a drawback. The Mini Moog had three oscillators but no dedicated LFO, so if you wanted an LFO you had to sacrifice an oscillator to have that functionality. But you had the choice. If you wanted a three oscillator sound, if you didn't want any LFO, you could have a three oscillator sound. With the Odyssey, it's two VCOs at most, but you do have the LFO. One of the drawbacks I find with the Odyssey is that with having a single LFO, the frequency you might want, say, for vibrato might not be the same frequency you want for, say, pulse width modulation of square waves. I tend to like quite a fast LFO for PWM, but with vibrato I tend to go for a slower, more subtle modulation. And of course you can't have both. Of course you could change the LFO frequency on the fly, but that would also change the pulse width modulation speed on the fly. But of course, whilst you're playing with your right hand modulating the LFO frequency with your left, you would then have to use your third hand to apply vibrato with the PPC pad. So yeah, not really an option. So yeah, that's a bit of a drawback, but such is the way of these things. The technology was expensive at the time. It would have made it even more expensive to add a second LFO. So below the low frequency oscillator, we have what's called the sample and hold mixer, which feeds the sample and hold. The mixer section has two sliders, blue topped one, so that tells you that it's related to VCO1, and a white topped one, which tells you that it's related to the noise generator. So the sample and hold mixer is just that. It's a mixer that allows you to mix up to two audio sources, VCO1, either waveform, with VCO2 square wave or the noise generator, and produces an audio output. And that audio output is the input to the sample and hold module. Sample and hold is a description of what is going on. You take a voltage and you sample it, you find out what the voltage is, sample it, and then you maintain that voltage. And then you sample it again, and you'll get a different voltage, and you hold that, and sample again, you get yet another voltage, and hold that until the next time you sample, and so on and so forth. Now, the frequency with which you sample that voltage on the Odyssey can be determined in two ways. And as you see from this arrow here down to this switch, in the upper position, the sample and hold frequency is determined by the LFO trigger, and in the bottom position it's keyboard trigger. And what that means is the frequency with which you resample the voltage can be determined by the LFO frequency, so slider up there, so you move it up, change the LFO frequency, and it resamples more frequently, more quickly. Or with keyboard triggering, it resamples every time you hit a note. So the frequency is determined by how quickly you play. The output of sample and hold is a voltage that changes that characteristic stair-stepping sound, because you tend to get seemingly random changes of voltage and big gaps between them. And that control voltage can be applied to other things. As we've seen, it can be applied to the pitch of the oscillators. So let's do that now with oscillator 1. And it's set to LFO triggering, as you can hear, because it's changing and I'm just holding a key down. With keyboard triggering, as I said, you can sample any voltage, and what the sample and hold mixer does is provide a voltage that is sampled and held. And so you've got a choice on the Odyssey of what voltage you use. And so all this time the left-hand slider, the blue one, has been up. This is VCO1. And the switch underneath, in the upper position, you've got the sawtooth output of VCO1. Bottom position, you've got the square wave output of VCO1. So it's sampling VCO1, holding it, sampling, holding. So the character of the sample and hold control voltage currently is determined by VCO1. And that's sawtooth. We'll move it to square wave. You can hear that the character of the sample and hold changes depending on the voltage that you are sampling and holding. And of course there is a second slider, and in the upper position you've got the noise generator, and in the lower you've got the square wave output of VCO2. So let's hear that. Before we do, this is VCO1 sawtooth again. And this is using the noise generator, sampling the noise generator. And as you would sort of expect, because noise is a lot more random and chaotic, the character of the sample and hold control voltage output is a lot more chaotic when what you're sampling is the noise generator. And of course, you could probably change this again by changing from pink noise, which we're currently using, to white noise. But I guess the subtle differences between white and pink noise aren't evident when you're just sampling it rather than hearing it as an audio source. Now, the other control for sample and hold, besides the triggering, whether it's LFO or keyboard triggered, the sampling, is output lag. And what this does is smooth out the stair steps. It's a bit like portamento for the output of the sample and hold. So you can smooth out the stair steps. So you can still get quite dramatic leaps, but they're a bit smoother. Of course, with the lag up high and the sample and hold control low, you can get really quite subtle changes on, in this case, the pitch of VCO1. Let's bring up VCO2. Apply a bit of, and just a bit of, sample and hold. And you get a characteristic sort of drifty oscillator sound. B- but drifty in the sense of not two oscillators beating against each other because the pitch is slightly different, but their tuning stability not being very stable, which of course is something you need to artificially introduce onto the Odyssey because its oscillators are pretty damn stable. And that gives you a pleasant, fat sound. If we were to bring the output lag down, then you would be able to hear more obvious changes to the pitch of oscillator 1. Which obviously would be more apparent if you push up the sample and hold slider a bit more. But that, pushing it up that far, it's not a particularly subtle effect. But it is a bit more pleasing with that smoothed output lag. So let's bring the output lag back down and go back to the mixer section. So we're currently sampling and holding the noise generator. Get rid of VCO2. And of course, we can switch this to the square wave output of VCO1. Sorry, of VCO2. And of course, that will probably at the moment sound no different to the output of VCO1 square wave because they're both set to the same pitch. That slider is stiff. But of course, we could change the pitch of VCO2 so you would get a different character of sample and hold control voltage because it would be sampling a different audio source. And that's just been using one wave or the other, and of course you can mix them together, get a more complex audio source input voltage that is then sampled and held, so you get a different character to the sample and hold. Change VCO1 to saw wave. And the character of the sample and hold changes again. And there's so much you can do because they are sliders, they're not on-off. So you can vary the mix of them as well as the audio sources. So you can have quite a lot of control over the character of the sample and hold.
And the only VCO control that we've played with has been the pitch of oscillator 2. We haven't even touched the pulse width controls, let alone the frequency modulation controls for either oscillator. And those will allow even more opportunities for altering the character of the sample and hold.